Hi, welcome to this new dev tips. Today I'm going to show you how you can connect JasperStuffed Studio to the database adapter. This database here can be any database out there, but here in this case we are going to use a case of MySQL. Without a further ado, let's go. Suppose that we just get our JasperSoft Studio, and then we are creating a report like this one. We create a new report that we want to connect to MySQL, which is Rollins. Then what we have to do is to go here, create a new report, and give the names. Can be anything. Hello. Then we click next, and when we come here you are presented with these options here, and then you have to create connect to our database. Here we only have the simple database, and but what you want to do is to connect to MySQL. Then you go here and create new, then scroll to the database that you want to use. Here is the case of MySQL. Then we go to database JDBC. Then we click next, and here you are presented with different JDBC connections. Here you want to use MySQL. This is the one you want to use. Then we select it, and here we have to enter the name of our database. The name of our database, we come here, and depending on your case here, our database here is Spring Boot. Here's the name of our database. Then we go back and enter here. Spring Boot. You also have to enter the username is Spring Boot, and the password. Here is the password, right? Then here we may enter here the name MySQL data adapter. Here's the name of our adapter, and if you click create to test here, you can see that it's not connecting because the driver couldn't be found. So what we have to do is to download the driver, MySQL driver. What we have to do is we come here and try to call MySQL, try to search, go to search my let's go to Google, it's better. Whatever, we search it. MySQL. Connector. Here, MySQL connector. Jar download. Right. And here you are presented with something like this. Link MySQL. This one. We go there, exactly. We go here. The first time you presented with this one, feel free to accept it after reading. Then we are presented with these options here. So what we have to do here is to go to, we want Windows platform independence. So we go to, we select the platform independence, and then we download the zip. It's only 4 MB, so we download that. No thanks, we don't want to sign up. And after a while our zip is downloaded. When it is downloaded, then we go here to download, and here we present it with the things. So what we do now is we right click that, then unlock it, unblock it to make it safe. Then we copy that here to any place here. We have just copy it here, and then after we unzip and extract it. After extracting, we are presented with these things, and here is the file that we are going to use. We are going to use this jar file here. So we copy the locations and then go back to our JasperSoft Studio, then come to driver parts, come to add here, and here we can add the locations. And we come here, we select the jar, add our driver, and then go back here and test. You can see, bam, it is successful. Right now we can connect to our database, MySQL database, directly from the JasperSoft. Then we can finish, and here we go to Spring Boot. Here is our database that we want to connect. We take it and put the name there, and we try to select. Now depending on the query that you want to do, you select all from the database. Next, we select all the fields. Next, this one by if you want. Next, congratulations, it's finished. It's finished. Then we come here, the fields that have been selected are these names, student ID names, program. So we take it here and paste them, then bring it up, make the design as we wish. And if we preview it now, we can see that now our report is working. We can get some data from the database. We can connect directly to the database and extract the data. So that is it. I hope that this video tutorial has been useful to you, and now you will be able to connect your Jasper TIBCO Jasper Soft Studio directly to your database. Stay tuned. Bye.